everyone, welcome back to Dragalia Lost. So the Trials of the Mighty have finally been released, and the first boss is indeed Thor. Those bosses have element and weapon restrictions, so you won't have the full use of your roster at your disposal against this particular sort of void battle-like bosses. So I am here today to make a guide. This guide will cover the fight itself, and then I will also give you a set of options for adventurers from what I've seen from other players and for myself to what works and doesn't work in both Adventurer and Dragons, of course. We won't skip Dragons. For more specific guides, as usual, I will leave them for the future. This one will be a more general guide for everything that you need to know for Thor. I will do a guide for every boss in this particular set of trials. Hopefully you will enjoy them. However, I want to say this. Those guides are early, so stuff might change. I've already seen that there are quick clears using some cheese comps, so if you want to go that way, probably the best way is to look for the cheese comp itself. I've heard that it is with Gleo and Albirius, something like that. For us, this is a sort of a guide if you want to tackle the boss in a normal way. So let's not waste any more time and jump into the fight itself. Indeed, as you are seeing on the home screen, I will be using our dear Xena, the original version that is also free. So you won't need to do any kind of gacha to get this particular adventure. So let's see what Xena can do against Master Co-op Thor. So this fight is very reminiscent of a void battle and of course the Thor boss battle in chapter 15. It's not a difficult fight by any means, also because you get two free lives that you can use to rest if you fail, and there isn't a survival bonus, so you don't really need to worry about it. So the fight starts with this thunder mechanic. As you can see, there will be three types of thunder. The first one will explode first, then the second one, and then the third one. You also will get a fourth thunder that will be red, so you can dodge it, that will chase you, and it will explode after the first purple thunder. So what you want to do is check where a purple thunder is about to explode, then go there and roll to dodge the red one, and then you can resume your attacks. After this, Thor gets in a standard attack rotation until you hit overdrive. As you can see, it is mostly standard attacks, and sometimes he casts a series of four red thunders, which you can easily dodge. Now we get into the main mechanic of the fight, which is this orb with a hit counter. Xena is stellar to deal with it, or a skill share with many hits. What you want to do is deal as many hits as you can to this orb before it expires, because if it is at 2 or higher counts, it will deal a ton of damage. How do you deal with this? As I told you, with Xena or another hit count skill share, like for example Mitsuhide or Galanot, any of those will work. When you break all three times the hit count, you will do the Thor Summer attack. I suggest to go into Dragon Mode because then you can dodge the Nihility, but up to you. Then he does this two orbs attack. You can dodge it by going towards the smaller orb, because there is where the dodge area is at, and you don't want to miss it because it deals a good amount of damage. Other than that, he doesn't really do a whole lot. He does have Nihility, however, as you can tell, so Grace, Kat, etc. are all dead in this fight, but we will get more into that later. How do you want to deal with this fight in general? So the fight is fairly quick, so the main way to deal with this is either to go in the cheese direction, which I want to do, because you know me, I don't really like to cheese stuff, or you go into the full damage, which will be to bring 3 DPS plus Xena, or the more offensive playstyle with Summer Veriga, where you don't really care about mechanics, and you just hit, hit, hit. As you can see, it is very easy to mess up the 3 Thunder thing, but it doesn't even deal a lot of damage, so I don't really think that you need to worry too much about it. I do think that debuff, so Shavu Jing, Galalex, etc., and Affliction, so once again Galalex, Albirius, etc., will help a lot to deal extra damage. And in general, wound units like Xena, like Veronica, like Clayman, etc. will have a good time because they do deal a lot of damage and aren't that much afflicted by Nihility. I guess Veronica does have an harder time because Grace doesn't work, but you can still make it worthwhile. Other than that, once again, this boss, much like other void battles and similar type of bosses, isn't too hard, so you should be able to get your clear very easily. I do suggest that you try Xena, since she's free, and as you can see, pretty easy to clear, even if I made one mistake earlier on into the fight. So now let's get into the rewards and see what Thor has to offer, and of course the Gala Yuden Spiral, and how much time you need to unlock it. So now we want to know how many weeks do I need to get the Galayud and Mana Spiral fully unbound. Well, you need 23 weeks of the Master Difficulty Daily Bonus. Don't worry if you haven't gotten the Master Daily Bonus today, because of course many of us found that it is not automatic. I went first thing first into the Master to record the fight, so I was lucky. But if you do the math, 23 weeks will be 4 weeks, so if you miss one, it still would have been 4 weeks, so you don't really have too much to worry about it. You will still end up with 3 of the yellow ones to spare and one of the red ones, so don't worry if today you did the standard, you won't miss out on anything compared to other users. You also want to know, of course, that the Master gives out the best amount of rewards in terms of daily bonus, and also the fight itself gives Origarchium, which is very valued and in general a very sweet farming stage to get it, because it's not that hard of a fight as you just saw. You can also double the daily bonus by using the 7 day pack. If there is a particular adventure that you like, this will put it the necessary days to get the Mana Spiral fully unbound to, I believe, 11 to 12, which will put it at 2 weeks, which is not too bad. Of course, this is paid, so up to your own discretion, but I left the option up to you to decide, because otherwise you would have missed it. What else is there to know? Well, this fight, much like Void Battles, gives free Wyrmites, so you get 150 from the complete first trial of every difficulty, then you get another 150 for the first clear of any Tor trial, and then you also get an extra 10 pool in Wyrmites if you clear 50 trials of the Mighty. This lasts for 20 days, so don't worry about it. We still have the Poseidon and the Zephyr one, which will also bring probably another 300, so there is a ton of Wyrmites, let me put it that way. I will leave the complete amount of Wyrmites that you get from Tor only on the left. Also, if you clear Tor every day, you do get an extra 25 on the daily bonus. So indeed, this is very reminiscent of our glory days with the Void Battles, and I am truly happy about it, because it does seem like the generosity is kinda back, which makes me really really happy. So what else do you need to know about the rewards? Well, not really that much. This is all that you need to know. Do remember that this fight switches in 7 days. We will get Poseidon and the Gala Elisan Mana Spiral, and then we get Zephyr and the Gala Ranzal Mana Spiral. Don't worry, however, because a Mana Spiral doesn't really need to be fully unbound to be usable. I guess this week we will end up around 58 of the Mana Spiral, which isn't too bad. You just need to unlock the skills and the passive to make it truly work. So maybe 2 weeks to make it shine for Galayuden will be a good amount. But this is it for the rewards. Now let's go see which adventure are truly worth in this fight, and also I will leave my Galazena build on the right. It is very easy to get Whippets. I don't believe I've used anything that is limited. Maybe the Halloween stuff, Wand one, but I don't really think so. So Zena, it is one adventurer that we don't really see too much around, and indeed with a good reason, because in Shadow we have a very solid meta, so I am truly happy to see her shine right here. I will do a little video on her against Tor in the future. Today we will do a general overlook at every adventurer that you can use. This fight is Shadow restricted, so you can only use Shadow Adventurer and Dragons, even in the backline, which is why I wouldn't worry too much about which co-op to use. But if you were to choose, Grace does have a unique co-op, and then probably Odric is a good one to get the dragon out, and Summer Verica does have a really nice chain co-op. Then, in terms of heroes, let's put it this way. I made an infographic with 3 markers. One is green with Charcoal, those are very good adventurers that probably will see a ton of use in this boss. The blue ones are decent ones, which can see play, but probably they are not the best of the best, which is fine. And then the red ones, which are either bad, doesn't mean that you cannot use them, but there are better options. And then if I cross them, they cannot be used because of Nahiridi, only Grace. Yaten, in some cases, you would argue that it doesn't truly work, but it still doesn't get fully denied from Nahiridi like Grace does, like Grace truly denied in any sort of way. So, who are the best adventurers for this fight? Albirius and Galagleo. You might think that they don't really work that well, but they have a very good cheese comp, which I saw got a clear of 14 seconds against this boss, so they are indeed very good. Albirius also is a sort of better Odric, so for dragon-related cheese comps, in general, is very very good. Galalex. So Galalex does not have access to her Agito weapon, her buff, which makes her slightly worse than average, but in general she has access to two debuff. One is the affliction poison and one is the death down, which makes her sort of decent. I do believe that she will see a lot of play for this exact reason, because having an affliction enabled plus also the death down does have a lot of worth. Also, her personal DPS is not that bad in general. You could argue that she's blue. In some cases, I would agree, but I've seen her in a lot of clears, and she's consistent. Xena. So, Xena, we saw her in this fight. Xena, why is she green? So, she's not the best of the best DPS, but think about this. She can slot in as a healer, so you don't really need to run the Agito skill. You can give her a healing skill and also then a multi-hit skill to deal with the orb. Plus her own multi-hit skill, she's the best hero to deal with the orb without going overboard, and she removes the need to have a healer in your team, which sometimes can lower the DPS. So in general she's very very solid. However, I will say this. Remember to use a Paralysis Res Wyrmprint, because in auto or if you are prone to mistakes, it will help a lot, because Paralysis is the only thing that Thor inflicts, and it can mess up adventurers by a lot. It also is one of the best chances to use this very gorgeous Giulietta print, so actually I am very happy about it, no question asked. Then we have Summer Veriga and Cleo, those two are healers. Summer Veriga is for a more offensive approach to the fight. If you don't really want to dodge stuff, she has her lifesteal skill, which helps a lot and doesn't get nullified by inability. And then her own healing skill, which still is one of the best ones in general, even in Shadow. Then you have Cleo. Why is Cleo there? Because she can remove paralysis, and as I just told you, this is very relevant indeed for this particular fight. Her defense buff I do believe gets removed, but it's not really that relevant because of her healing skill, so there it is. For the blue ones, as I told you, they are good options, and in general they will see a lot of play, but they are not the highest tier options that you would aim for, because Odric is a budget Albirius, Berserker is a sort of a versatile hero that is good for auto but in co-op doesn't really shine, Veronica doesn't have access to Grace, so her utility kinda lowers because she can die very easily, Clayman is a worse sort of Galagreo in some ways, Altimia actually is very good, but I do believe that she lacks the proper setting to be the best of the best, because heroes like Albirius and Galagreo exist, which makes she's comps a lot better. Maybe I will put her within blue and green, she's actually not that bad. And then Heimwald, well, Heimwald is basically a DPS in this fight, because if you want to run a healer, it is better to have Galazena if you want a more versatile style, since she can deal with the orb, which is way better, since it is the only mechanic of this fight, and then you won't have to deal with it at all if Xena exists. So, this is of course my opinion, subject to change if we get new adventurers, if some stuff changes, but in general, the general idea is that green or blue, you are safe to run them. Red, I will think twice. Crossed, do not run them at all because they do not work. Now for dragons, once again, very very quickly, we have green option in Hyctonius and Arsene. Well, Hyctonius, we kinda knew that he will be one of the best because he just released, but indeed, he doesn't get denied at all by Nahiridi. Arsene replaces Kat as the best skill damage dragon because Kat indeed does not work. We just found out, and I did like 10 runs with the gut before finding out myself, so here it is. Ramiel is for cheese comps with Odric, so I did indeed put him there. Azazel for healers works really really well. Shinobi is the alternative to Arsene if you don't have him, and it works quite well indeed. Then for blue we have a ton of dragons that work in some situation, but of course you have better option in other options, which doesn't really make a lot of sense said about this. Red are mostly the welfare dragons, so you know what I mean by that, they don't have the best of skills and kinda compared to 4 stars. I didn't put 4 stars over here because you should have a fully unbound 4 star by now. They are good options if you don't have any good option in the 5 star category. The red circle dragons are basically 4 star dragons, put it this way. Apart from Ctonius, but I don't really believe that the base Ctonius works as well in this fight. Nyarlathotep, the same idea. So, this is it for Dragons. Not really that surprising that Arsene, Ike, Tonius and Ragnar are up there, because in general they are very, very good. Okay, so as I told you, this is a very fast guide indeed, because there isn't a whole lot to cover, but hopefully it does help you clear this particular fight. I will be back next week with the Poseidon one. Do remember to check out the weapons and the element for the fight to prepare a good adventure. Now that we know that Nihility is in the fights, you can kinda prepare around it by learning what adventurers have buff and if their buff gets denied. Just get into Lilith and then see if the buff gets dispelled or not, or even in this fight, so not in this fight you cannot. I don't really believe that you can heal it. I'm not really sure, but I guess we will see next week. For today, this has been it. I have very much enjoyed playing with Xena once again, one of my favorite heroes and girls in this game in general, so very, very happy to use her. Hopefully, if you are going to use Xena, this guide will help you. If not, let me know who you use, and if you manage to use Yaden and make it work, let me know, or Rodrigo even. I wasn't really sure, to be honest, but maybe they work, maybe they don't, who knows at this point. I do think that they are not the best for sure. For today, this has been Hunter Lodge. Remember to give a like and a sub if you want to support the channel. I will review the Galahuder Mana Spiral whenever we get an upgrade to both of his skills, so that I can see if they change something about them. For now, I will refrain from reviewing it because it is not complete and I don't want to give half-assed reviews, so that's my opinion about it. But once again, for today, this has been it. I am Hunter Lodge, this has been Xena for the fight, and of course Thor has been defeated, and maybe one day he will join my dragon ranks with Galador. But for today, this is it. Thank you very much once again, and I'm out. Bye!